Latest update on the Travers Stakes 2024. Let's find out who's in, who's out, and who's considering the Travers Stakes. It is August the 1st, and they'll be painting the canoe at the end of the month at Saratoga. Fierceness is back under consideration for the Travers Stakes. Thorpedo Anna also going to the Travers Stakes, going to become the filly to try to attempt to win the Travers Stakes at a mile and a quarter. A Travers update, Mindframe is now out on the latest update, but Fierceness back into consideration. After Mindframe now dropping out of the Travers Stakes, they are going to consider Fierceness back into the Travers Stakes. Let's watch the replay of the Jim Dandy, of course, at a prep race at Saratoga. It was Fierceness making his move on the turn when post time ended up fading on the turn. Sierra Leone getting caught, having to go to the rail down the lane. But Fierceness looks like his final two races of the year could be the Travers Stakes and then point to the mile and a quarter Breeders' Cup Classic in November, which this year is going to be at Old Del Mar. Now, Fierceness came out of the Jim Dandy Stakes. He got a 103 buyer, and for Fierceness, that is his third buyer speed figure over 100. Of course, his 110 in the Florida Derby earlier in 2024. Now, Thorpedo Anna, they announced last Saturday that she is pointing to the Travers Stakes. She schooled at Saratoga over the weekend. She was calm at the gate. Of course, she broke just a step slow in the CCA Oaks at the beginning of that race. It looks like she is going to now train towards the Travers Stakes 2024. Now, the last filly to win the Travers was not 1915. It's been over 100 years since a filly has won the Travers. Let's take a look at the recent runners to run in the modern day Travers Stakes. You had Sakata in 1962. She finished last. 1974, the brilliant filly, Chris Evert. And of course, she was third in that race. Devona Dale was fourth. And in 2018, Wonder Godot finished last in the Travers Stakes. She was a little bit overmatched in that spot. She had beat the boys up in Canada. So Thorpedo Anna looking to win the Travers Stakes 2024. She did get a 95 buyer in the CCA Oaks. Other news for the Travers, Mindframe is now out. Of course, he was second in the Haskell, second in the Belmont Stakes. Looks like he's got a bruised foot, and he couldn't quite catch Dornoch late in that Haskell Stakes. He is targeting the Pegasus Stakes as his main objective early in 2024. He finishes 2023 with four starts. He did not race as a two-year-old. Now, the Travers field starting to form. We've got Dornoch, a grade one winner in the Belmont Stakes and the Haskell Stakes. Unmatched Wisdom, 3-for-3 lifetime for trainer Chad Brown. Honor Marie, fourth in the Belmont Stakes. Sierra Leone, second in the Jim Dandy Stakes. Fierceness, the winner of the Jim Dandy, winner of the Florida Derby. Thorpedo Anna, three-time grade one winner. And then you've got Batten Down, third in the Jim Dandy. He won the Ohio Derby and also won a maiden race at Churchill Downs. Sees the gray. It looks like he might consider the Travers Stakes. Didn't do a lot of running in the most recent race, the Jim Dandy, but Coach Dwayne Lucas said he didn't have energy going into that race. So Sees the gray going to possibly point to the Travers. Breeders' Cup Classic rankings have come out. The first rankings for 2024. We've got Dornoch leading the way, National Treasure, Fierceness, Forever Young. It looks like he's going to have two preps, one prep before the Breeders' Cup Classic and then run in the Breeders' Cup Classic. He has not run since the Kentucky Derby. He is scheduled to run next in October in Japan. Sierra Leone, Kings Barnes, of course, the winner at Churchill Downs in his most recent start. A little bit of an upset winner in the Stephen Foster. And Senior Buscador, who is pointing to the Pacific Classic, he rounds out those Breeders' Cup Classic rankings, week number one, 2024. Now, Breeders' Cup, winning your in races coming up. We've got races coming up at Del Mar. We've got Colonial Downs, the Arlington Million, Deauville, France. We've got Saratoga. So we're within 95 days of the Breeders' Cup 2024. We'll be giving you daily updates as we get closer to September. Meanwhile, the Jerkins, the undercard on the Travers Stakes, that's for three-year-old colts. We've got World Record, Jefferson Street, the 1-2 finishers in the Amsterdam, General Partner, a recent winner for Chad Brown, Domestic Product, another Chad Brown runner, and Speak Easy, who recently won at Saratoga. That one's trained by Todd Pletcher, 2-for-2 lifetime. He is going to be considering the Jerkins Stakes later on at the end of August. Now, World Record did pick up a 101 buyer in that victory in the Amsterdam, and he basically went wire to wire at 6-to-1 odds. Now, summer racing continues. We've got the Travers Stakes, we've got the Pacific Classic, the Alabama Stakes, Kentucky Downs meeting coming up September. Then we've got the Del Mar Debutante for two-year-old fillies, the Del Mar Futurity for two-year-old colts, and the Grade One Hopeful, always a big race at Saratoga, usually a prep for the Grade One Champagne at Belmont Park, which of course they're running at Aqueduct this year as they continue the Belmont renovations. Now, the Whitney Stakes field has been drawn, a 12-horse field led by the morning line favorite, National Treasure. He won the Met Mile, he won the Pegasus Stakes. You've got Post Time out of post position number one. First Mission, a disappointing effort in the last race at the Stephen Foster. Cruppy, a winner last time out. Tumbarumba and Bright Future. Bright Future winning at Monmouth Park. So the Whitney Stakes, we do have a preview up of that race already up on the channel. Don't forget the 5 shocking upsets in the Kentucky Derby. You can watch that video. Some of my favorite long shot winners of the Kentucky Derby. And I will be having free racing picks for the Whitney Stakes Day. 13 races on the card. That comes out Saturday morning. If you've already signed up, you're good to go. If you haven't signed up yet, sign up below in the description. And we're also going to have picks for Travers Day, Breeders' Cup Day, and some other big racing days still to come this fall and summer. Now, who are your top Travers contenders? Do you think Thorpedo Anna has a shot? What about Honor Marie, Sierra Leone, and First Fierceness? Leave a comment on the runners you're considering early on for the Travers Stakes 2024. Should be an exciting Travers Day card. Of course, Grade One races that day. You've got the Jerkins, you've got the Travers, you've got the big race for the fillies, and a nice turf race in the Sword Dancer. Travers Day 2024, we'll continue to keep you updated. Leave a comment. D. Wayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.